We're in McIntosh County on the coast of Georgia. It's really a beautiful place. It's one of the least developed areas really on the whole east coast of the U.S. My name is Meryl Alber. I'm a professor in the Department of Marine Sciences at the University of Georgia. This is called SaltEx. It's one of our research projects, and SaltEx is an effort to evaluate what might happen with rising sea level and how that might affect coastal marshes. People think about rising sea level. They think often about things that might happen at beaches and in ocean water and how that might affect coastal systems. But one of the other things that happens with sea level rise is you get the saltwater will move further upstream. And one of the habitats that it will hit as it moves further upstream is freshwater marsh. We're in a freshwater marsh now that doesn't usually ever see salty water. But with rising sea level, this could change. And so that's what we're studying. We are taking salt water and mixing it, there's a mixing tank that you'll see, with fresh water from the river. So we're mixing those together, and then you'll see we're pumping that into our experimental sites to artificially increase the salinity of the plots. We're not exposing them to full strength seawater because that's not really realistic for, if you think about sea level rise and saltwater intrusion, it will be a slow, gradual increase in salt.
We have to get a little bit further in. I don't think anybody's really set up this kind of large manipulative experiment looking at saltwater intrusion. My name is Chris Kraft, and I've been working at SaltEx since its inception about 4 years ago. And we measure chloride, sulfate, hydrogen sulfide gas, and we also measure nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, and carbon. And these tidal fresh wetlands actually, there are a lot of denitrifying bacteria. They take nitrate, which is a water pollutant, water quality pollutant, and they convert it to N2 gas and put it back into the atmosphere where it belongs. You add seawater to these, it poisons these bacteria, and so their ability to remove nitrogen and keep the water clean is going to be compromised.
It takes energy to handle salt water, and there are not very many plants adapted to being flooded with salt water. And really, most freshwater organisms do not have those adaptations. So as soon as they're exposed to salt, most of them die. If you go further upstream, you start to get trees, so tidal fresh forest. Tidal fresh forest trees like cypress are, again, very susceptible to changes in salinity. If they get hit with salt water, then it will cause the trees to die. And that isn't necessarily through sea level rise, but it is analogous because we know that there's been increases in salt water flooding those areas. If those habitats go away, there's no place else for the tidal fresh forest to move further upstream because there's areas that are developed. So there's concern about what will happen to the wildlife that depend on these areas.
You know, there's some predictions that sea level may rise 2 meters in the next 100 years. And I would say that would be a catastrophic sort of change because the rate would be so much faster than these wetlands could sort of build sediment and keep pace with them.